Ponder me this, YouTube. I just had another thought, right? So, time's not real, right? And I was sitting here like, because if time is real, how do we have 365 days? But each day doesn't have a name. Each year doesn't have, say, a name. It's just a year. And then it begs to ponder the question of like, so why did we have BC before Christ? Because if in the Bible, you know, it took Jesus to come here and save everybody, what happened to everyone's souls, you know, when they passed on? Before Christ came, did they all just go to this imaginary hill? Because I'm pretty sure none of them probably got into heaven, you know, being how the Bible wants to describe God and everything like that. You know, I just look at the Bible as a storybook because it's like, you want me to believe in a magical wizard that sits up above and just watches the chaos rain and people die and people this and people that. No, there's another meaning behind certain things, I feel. But there's always a deeper meaning behind anything. You know, you're just hitting the tip of the iceberg. But I just had this thought, I'm like, what does AD stand for? Because I thought AD stood for after death. Nope, it stands for the year of our Lord during the time that Jesus was alive, right? So you have the time period before Christ, then you have the time that he was alive. You would think that they would have a time period after his death, which acronyms would be AD, you know, because if he was real ever, I mean, because he's not here now, you know? So it's like, what is this time period we on? Then you have like the Mesopotamian calendar, the Julian calendar, the Gregorian calendar. And then I got to thinking, hold on. Over here in America, or I guess worldwide right now, we go by the Gregorian calendar, right? Which is set 8 years ahead of the Mayan calendar, right? So I got to thinking, I said, hold up. In the Gregorian calendar, because I was born in 1991, that makes me 30 years old. But if we backtrack 8 years, so that would actually mean I was born or I arrived here to this realm in 1983. Let's see, hold on. 1983, which means that I actually am 8 years younger, so I'm not even 30. So I'm really like 22, right? So then I'm like, hold up. And I just got to pondering, because I'm like, how can time be real? Because they created a calendar that's 8 years ahead. They want us to go by that calendar. But yet, the Pope and all of them go by like the older calendar, the Julian calendar or some kind of calendar. But it's just like, why did you create a calendar 8 years ahead? Are you trying to make it, are you trying to like tell the future? So then I got to pondering like, maybe I am an 80s baby. Because, I mean, if I was born in 1983 versus 1991, I'm still like an 80s, 90s baby. I don't know. It's just weird. And then, you know, why do we only got the same 7 damn days, y'all? Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. And it repeats and it repeats and it repeats. And it sounds like a broken fucking record, y'all. Over and over and over. 365 days. How did they come up with the months? And why do the months repeat? Because I would think that time, everything would constantly change. You know what I'm saying? You know, because mind you, before Christ, did Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, did all these weekdays exist? These motherfuckers didn't have watches back in Jesus' day. Or before him. So how did they keep up with time? Ponder these things. Ponder, ponder, ponder. So, a lot of people will probably say, well, they used the sun. Yeah, they very well could have used the sun. But check this out, though. How could they have used the sun when we had two suns? Because we're not, the solar system as you know it to be, or that you were taught in these programming centers, is a lie. We are a binary system or something. Yeah, binary. We're a binary system, which means we have two suns. That's new to us. But then again, when you think about time, now in this day and age, these little kiddos that are in these programming centers nowadays, they'll never know Pluto is a planet. Pluto to them is a fucking moon. How about that be a shock to your system? It's like, hold up, hold up, hold up, hold up, hold up. Pluto is a planet. I know this because I was taught that Pluto was a planet. Now you're teaching that Pluto was not a planet. It is a moon. How do we know Pluto isn't another galaxy or dimension, like a gateway or a stargate or a gateway to another dimension, reality, and world? How do we know Pluto is not that? Since y'all taught me that Pluto was a planet and you're now teaching these babies that it's a moon. A moon to what fucking planet? I'd like to know. It's not a Saturn moon. It's not a Neptune moon. So what planet is a Pluto a moon to? I got questions. I need answers. So again, you know? Yeah, ponder these things. I think time is definitely an illusion, because when you think about the old days, where, first off, let's get this straight. When, back in Moses' day, right? We're gonna go with the Bible stories. When they got lost in the desert for 40 years, how the fuck did you know that it was 40 years? How did you keep track of time to know that it was 40 years? You didn't have a watch. Did they have days of the week? How did they know when to recycle these days of the week? How did they know when to celebrate certain things? I feel the only way that they really truly knew was to look to the stars. Yeah, you could follow the sun from sunrise to sunset. Okay, cool. That gives you an idea of what time it is. But now the question is, at nighttime, how do you know the hours of the night? Because the moon doesn't just, you know, rise and set like the sun does. Because if you notice, as the sun is setting, sometimes you can see the moon already in the sky. So sometimes when the sun is setting, you can still see the moon in the sky. Sometimes even while the sun is up, you can see the moon in the sky. So the moon has no rise or sunset. The moon is the moon, apparently. And then let's take a journey through history. Shaka Zulu, the Dogon tribe, accounts that they've said there was no moon. The moon didn't exist. So if the moon once upon a time didn't exist, where the fuck did it come from? What happened to the second sun that was here that the moon replaced? Now, this is something that people who love conspiracy theorists, and we all know that the CIA made it up. They even admitted to making it up. Hell, the CIA, the FBI, the NSA, NASA, all of them are under the same boat. They know about aliens. They've been knowing about the aliens since the 1920s. You know, they just don't want the mass population to know what is going on. I mean, ponder this. Why the fuck did Trump create Space Force right before he left office? Space Force. And then he made videos. Yeah, we want our brightest and our strongest to be in Space Force. Okay, so first off, supposedly the smartest branch of or hardest branch to get into is Air Force, because you got to be real, real smart. You got to take all these tests and ace all these tests to get into the Air Force, right? So how much smarter does a person have to be to get into Space Force? You want the strongest and brightest to be in Space Force. Who is that? Whatever happened to those people that got in the rocket and they were launched to Mars like 5 years ago? I haven't heard nothing about that in the media. They say it takes 5 years to make it to Mars. That's what they say. Who is they? Good question. They is them. Who is them? Them. No. I'm asking you a question. Who is they and who is them? They is them, and them is those folks. FBI, CIA, NASA, NSA. Who are they? The people who make up your government? The people who do investigations? The people who create these laws? Bullshit-ass laws at that. They're the people that want to help wrangle the farm, I guess you could say. If all of us are sheep people, they're the wranglers trying to keep us herded together, want to keep us dumbed down. They don't want us asking questions, because when we start asking questions, they have to come up with answers. And when they get to bullshitting, they get to bullshitting, because they'll give you an answer, but then you be like, that don't make sense. Then they start lying, and you know that they be lying. They be lying. You ain't gotta lie. You ain't gotta lie, Craig. You ain't gotta lie. But that's the point of history. His story. Y'all be lying like some motherfuckers. But I'm just saying, like, that's the problem with society being where it is. We should always question everything. Question everything. They're trying to force this hot sauce 19. You know what I'm saying? I don't even know if I could really say the word, because, shoot, they be flagging people's videos and all of this. But, or I mean, some people use cold words, like this one YouTuber I listen to. She says haircut for that hot sauce, for that macaroni and cheese, for that jab. You know, I mean, damn, we got to use cold words and stuff. Man, when my big bro told me about mac and cheese, I was like, man, I do feel hungry. I'm thinking a nigga talking about macaroni and cheese. He ain't talking about the macaroni and cheese we eat. He talking about that mac and cheese. You know what I'm saying? I was actually kind of disappointed that my uncle ended up getting it. I was just like, ah, damn, Unc. But we are all sovereign beings, meaning we are in control of our avatars. So I'm not going to give my avatar anything that I don't deem as natural. You know, I got a problem with the fact that they're paying people to take it. Uncle Joe, was trying to mandate that you can't work unless you get it. You can't go into stores unless you get it. If you don't take a stand for something, you'll fall for anything. And you got to think, and I mean, the previous generations, y'all some selfish ass bastards. You know that? Y'all some selfish ass bastards. You are a selfish ass bastard. And I said it 3 times for a reason. Let it soak in. Because I noticed that the demographics that watch my channel are 35 to 65 years old. Y'all some bastards. Y'all are. You want to know why you're a bastard? Because you all have created generational trauma, generational curses. You all have, you know, taken what you were taught and you never asked questions. My generation, I'm proud of us. I'm proud of us. Because we're calling out the pedophiles in our families, child molesters in the families. We're the ones healing generational traumas, breaking generational curses. I'm proud of us. Oh, we need a pat on the back to all of us millennials. And if you don't know if you're a millennial, millennials, I believe, based on the definition of millennials, are definitely, I think, from like 83 to about 95. That's a whole generation. Yeah, matter of fact, that is a whole generation. You want to know why? Because all of our Plutos are in Capricorn. We are one generation. Only the babies that are about 95 till about 2000, 2001, their Pluto is in Scorpio, I believe. I think that's what it was. Shit, I fucking forgot exactly. I should have wrote it down, and I can't really look at it because this is a moment I should have went and pulled up my laptop right now. But anyways, point is, you can Google the generations based on Pluto. And the reason why I say that, now see what I mean by everything comes full circle? What was I talking about in the beginning? That I was taught Pluto was a planet, not a moon. Anyways, but one thing I can tell you is Pluto tells you the generations and where they are. The Pluto right now is in Aquarius. It is the age of Aquarius. All things are being revealed. If you're a liar, it's going to fucking come out that you're a liar. If you're a cheater, you're going to get busted cheating. You know what I'm saying? If you're a thief, you're going to get caught stealing. You cannot deny the truth. Not now. Nope. This shit is over at this point. The Matrix is breaking down. I actually look forward to The Matrix because I was talking to a friend about the trailer. I haven't gotten to watch the trailer myself, but supposedly The trailer is based on Neo being asleep. Or instead of Neo taking the red pill with Morpheus and exiting the Matrix and then, you know, going back in to try to rescue these people, he decides that he wants to stay asleep.
But then as he stays asleep, I'm going to actually go and watch the trailer sometime today. And then because I've watched it myself instead of just talking about it or asking questions, I know because it's going to be released, I think, December 17th on HBO Max or whatever. So I'm very curious because, you know, The Matrix has been telling us what is going on. There's a lot of people that have been awake for years, you know, very enlightened, intelligent beings that came to try to wake people up to what the hell is really going on. You know, I like to use this analogy. You know, people, I don't care whether you consider me crazy. You can get the hell up off my channel. Nobody told you to click on this motherfucker and watch. You know, you can go ahead and exit. If you disagree or you got something to say, that's fine. Go ahead. But at the end of the day, this is my channel. This is what I think. This is what I, you know, you're free to comment below, you know, subscribe, like, share, all that good stuff, you know. But I'm not the only one that thinks these certain things. I always wondered, why is it a phenomenon that Black people that I don't even know, we've literally have had the same childhood. In every Black family, we know the particular furniture that our folks had. Curtains, couches, tables, lamps, dishes. And when we see these passed down on the internet, the new generations are just like, oh, it's just a cup. No, it's not just a cup or just this. It was a symbol of a generation because it was in every Black household across America. Which goes to teach you that we are all connected. We are all one. Because how is it that we were literally raised? I was raised in a generation where my parents, grandparents, stop running in and out the house. Either you're in or you're out. And you had to make a decision. It's like, shoot, I want to go back outside, but shit, I just came inside because I was hot. I'm just trying to cool off a little bit. Well, cool off under the shade of a tree. Shade of a tree? We got AC for a reason. And then, you know, you get locked out. You got to knock on the door. I'm thirsty. Well, there's a water hose outside. I don't want to drink out the water hose. But when you thirsty, you're going to drink out that water hose. You had to let it run for a while, too, because as soon as you get it turned on, it's hot as hell. You know, you got to let it run for a minute. It get lukewarm, then it get cold. Man, them was the good old days. The new generations, man, they would never know what it was like to play outside. I mean, they will, some of them. But for the most part, technology is raising them. But anyways, back to what I was saying about the generations and Pluto signifying the generations. Like, you guys can go and Google this. Don't take anything that I say for face value. You can go Google it. Because, I mean, when I have questions, that's what I do. That's what the hell. Look, we're in the age of technology. So, I mean, I'm on my smartphone recording this video right now. The smartphone was created to learn, to educate thyself. Because these little programming centers called schools, your little fuck-ass religion and church, ain't none of that gonna teach you shit. I can tell you right now, I was in the church, religious and shit, for years. It never once fed my fucking soul. My soul always was hungry. My soul was unhappy, like, this some bullshit. Matter of fact, I'd be up in the church fucking sleep. Every motherfucking Sunday, sleep. Ain't hearing a goddamn thing that my granddaddy preaching about, because, nigga, it don't resonate with me. And on top of that, nigga, you was a whole pimp, a whole gangster out here in these streets back in the 30s and stuff, and you gonna turn into a preacher? Oh, I changed my life around. Yeah. All right. If you say so. If you say so, old man. If you say so. What you talking about don't resonate with me. But that's why I say, like, the older generations, y'all some bastards, man. Y'all knew shit wasn't right. But how many of y'all actually tried to make a change? What did it take for Rosa Parks to be like, I'm not sitting in the back of the bus. All the seats back there is full. I'm about to sit up here in the white section. And then next thing you know, a boycott started. And next thing you know, now we could ride the bus or whatever and sit wherever we want. Frankly, I ain't even trying to be on the fucking bus. So did she fight that fight in vain? Because most people in my generation, we don't catch the damn bus. We got our own car to go to and from when we want to. So was her fight in vain? I'll say no. Because at that time, a lot of black people depended on the bus at that day and time in that era. I remember dressing up as Rosa Parks for like fifth grade doing a bibliography report on her. You know? I believe she's passed on now, but you know, she stood for something, you know? Not even any of the men were, you know, brave enough, courageous enough to do what she did. She was jailed, ridiculed, but she started, but a whole movement got started behind her. What did it take for Martin Luther King and Malcolm X? See, Martin Luther King and Malcolm X, I think X-Men was kind of based on both of them. Martin Luther King was like Professor Xavier. He was real passive and, well, there's another way. We don't have to go by violence. But Magneto and Malcolm X, they was on that, nah, fuck that. Hit me in the face, I'm a bitch slap your ass back. Malcolm X was a gangster. I feel like if y'all older generations would have tried shit Malcolm X's way, shit would be totally different now, I guarantee you. Because you can never have peace without war. And that's just facts. So, a lot of y'all want to cling to that Bible and cling to Jesus and get down on your knees. You know what I never liked about getting down on your knees and praying? It's because it's like sucking a dick. You're getting down on your knees to suck that dick. And what are you doing? Sucking Jesus' dick? Why the fuck you on your knees for? Y'all preach, the church people preach that shit, come as you are. Alcoholics, people who manage to get a drug addiction, come into the church, but you judge them. I've witnessed my great-grandmother, my grandmother, even my mom, and her boyfriend, and all the people in the church, because, you know, we didn't convert it goddamn denominations, I don't know how many times. The last denomination we were was a Seventh-day Adventist. You know? I felt like they were a cult. But You're playing fashion show. Who dressed the best this week? Who can sing the best? Who can cook the best? Who got the best career? Who makes the most money? Who this? Who that? In the church? Y'all don't even understand. Like, I don't know what the hell I said. Understand. Like I'm a whole godfather over here or godmother. You got to understand something, old ones. The younger generations, we don't take no shit. We come with the last generation. We fight for what we want to change. You come into our house, we kill you. You step on our toes, we fuck you up. I don't even know why I'm talking to that accent, y'all. I'm joked out as a motherfucker over here. But I'm speaking facts. You gotta know that I'm speaking facts. y'all generation accepted what the hell they told you. How was it the Tuskegee experiment happened? Oh, hey, we wanna inject you with these vitamins. Well, I mean, come on. And I get it. Y'all was poor back in the day. You know, y'all was struggling. Y'all had the crack epidemic, and you know, y'all had y'all own battles. I get it back then. But you know what? Not only did you genetically pass down your traumas to our generation, and I never understood why I had PTSD. I ain't never been to war, but my great granddaddy has. I ain't never, you know, been raped or nothing like that, but my mom was close. Some ancestor of mine was. These traumas passed down genetically, generationally. And that's also why I don't judge. I'm judging, but I'm not judging. And what I'm saying is, when I call the older generations bastards, that's because y'all was some pussies. Y'all didn't stand up for what y'all believed in. Y'all didn't believe in mental health. Y'all didn't believe in, you know, trying to heal yourself. You just went through life. Man, my mama and my daddy took the branch off the tree and beat my ass. I'm gonna do it to my kids. And all you did was create pain. You walk into a store, you see a white kid yelling at their mom, "Fuck you, mommy." And then you slap your child in the face and you be like, "Don't you ever in your life talk to me like that." The kid ain't even did nothing to you. How you just gonna slap me upside my head and I didn't do nothing? And then you didn't even motherfucking apologize. You was in the wrong, old generations, slapping us upside our heads and we ain't did shit. You only slap a motherfucker upside their head when they done something. Us millennials, we can discipline the youth without putting our hands on them. Now, some of them are wild, but think about this. What was that song that came out? I think it came out back in the 80s. "We were born to be wild." I don't even know who sings that song, but I remember hearing it on TV or in some movie and shit. I don't know who sings "We were born to be wild." But when you think about it, we were. And my generation, we're the ones changing this shit, trying to take it back to nature. We're the ones, you know, going into our spirituality, breaking away from that religious bullshit, which was nothing more than manipulation and control. Do you know that a lot of pastors and bishops and all of them in the fucking church, they have to go to a secret meeting and gathering in the Vatican? And the Pope tells them what the fuck to teach us out of that Bible? Because you notice we ain't never read that whole motherfucker in there. Every time I turn around, same motherfucking verses. Turn to Corinthians 3:17. How many times we got to go to John 3:19? How many times we got to go to Genesis? We go to the same fucking books. The same fucking books. Why ain't y'all talking about the Apocrypha? Enoch, Esther, I forgot all them people. I got a whole Apocrypha book in there. I ain't even read that motherfucker yet. I need to, because goddamn King James Bible ain't enough for me. How the hell is there about 107? And I say about 107 because I don't remember the exact number. But y'all only want to teach from the same, like, fucking 33 books. There's all these different books that make up the Bible, but you got the King James Version of the Bible. The Catholic people got their Bible. You know, what's them people that go door to door? "Have you heard about Jesus?" What the hell they called? I can't think at the tip of my head. You know who I'm talking about. The name will come to me in a minute. But you know what I'm saying? The older generations never questioned things. Or if you did have questions, you never voiced it. Because I guarantee you weren't the only one with that particular thought. A lot of thoughts that we have don't even be our own thoughts. Ain't that crazy? You know? But that's why I said meditate day and night. Because when you meditate and you go within and you understand you, stop trying to understand everything outside of yourself. Because when you understand you, when you understand your dark and your light and the duality of yourself, you can then understand others around you. My generation, we're healing. My generation, we walked away from the church. I was scared to denounce Jesus. I was scared, like, what? But you know what? I also had the thought that, shit, if this spiritual shit don't work out for me, I can always repent and get on my knees and Jesus dick. He's old. It says, sinners, you can always repent. Well, if I'm a sinner, Bible wise, see, a lot of Bible people ain't gonna like this shit, but I don't give a fuck. And you know what? A lot of my family and a lot of my friends are still Christians and on that Jesus shit and all of that. I respect it. Hell, some of my family and my friends believe that they're Moors, they're Hebrew Israelites. I ain't knocking y'all. Y'all believe that shit. I'ma believe what my soul tells me is truth. Seek me and ye shall find. How do you find something if you don't ask questions? That's the point I'm getting at, folks. Ask questions. I always wondered, why is there a particular way to pray? You have to say this prayer. Why? You have to get down on your knees. Why? You gotta pay 10%, otherwise you're going to hell. Why? You gotta do this and you gotta do that. Why? Why? Ain't no answers. I'm just saying, ask questions. Questions lead to answers. Those answers come from within. Damn, my skin look good. Hold up, boy. Ooh, I'm sorry, y'all. I'm sitting here looking at my face. I said, dang, my face is extra clear. Baby, let me tell you, the glow up is real when you get into yourself and you dig into yourself. Society taught us, men and women, that crying makes you weak. Crying actually truly cleanses the soul. It cleanses the soul, and it also releases grief. Because you can't get into your higher self unless you unlock your heart chakra. How do you unlock your heart chakra? You have to release your grief. That's just facts. Aang the Avatar literally taught us step by step how to activate each chakra. Root chakra, release fear. Sacral chakra, release guilt. Solar plexus, release shame. Heart chakra, release grief. Throat chakra, release the lies. The brow chakra, the third eye, release the illusions. Crown chakra, release all earthly attachments. Excuse me. And in doing those things, that is how You tap into self. These are not things that I was taught. They're learned, but they were only learned after I had to deprogram my mind. You do know that the programming centers, schools, they teach us one thing. Because, and this is when I knew that everything was a lie. Everything that you think is truth is a lie, and everything that you thought was a lie is the truth. It's flipped backwards. Reverse psychology. I was taught tomatoes were vegetables. Tomatoes have seeds inside them, which makes them a fruit. Potatoes are vegetables because they don't have a fruit. Yes, tomatoes grow on the ground, just like potatoes, but they have seeds which make them a fruit. A fruit that is good for your root chakra. The color of fruit, you know, they resonate with each chakra. So I love strawberries. They're red. They you know, go into the root chakra. I like bananas. They go into my solar plexus. Oranges, they go into your sacral. Green apples or green pears, heart chakra. You know what I'm saying? Blueberries, brow chakra, throat chakra. You know what I'm saying? Now, don't get me wrong. Grapes. Man, I don't know about y'all, but it's hard to find some damn grapes that got seeds in them. I've gone to farmers markets, Whole Foods, Sprouts. I can't find no damn grapes with seeds in them. Hey, y'all. They really trying to kill us out here with these fucking GMO foods. But let he who has eyes see and know. Prince said it best. There's a war on the mind. And the prize is the soul. Ponder on that shit. Matter of fact, you can go find that very episode on YouTube. Prince was wearing some glasses and he had some sunglasses on. And the sunglasses actually covered up this eye too. At the time, I wasn't really awake. You know what I'm saying? I wasn't tapped into myself. But I was just like, I heard those words. And I was like, what the fuck you mean there's a war for my mind and the prize of the soul? Because a lot of these rappers are out here selling out, sucking dick, selling their souls for a record deal, some millions of dollars. My soul ain't worth none of that shit. I mean, don't get me wrong. As a woman, yeah, I'm gonna suck some dick. I'm gonna suck my nigga dick. But that's beside the point. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking about these rappers are men sucking other men's dicks. That's not natural. You know what I'm saying? That's what I'm getting at. Now, if you're gay or whatever, if you're an alphabet person, you know, I ain't got no quarrels against you. I mean, shoot, live your best motherfucking life before you leave this motherfucker. But my thing is, don't be trying to push your lifestyle on me. That's the only issue I have with some of them motherfuckers. They think because the shit they on, I gotta be on that. Nah, you keep your bedroom shit over there, all right? That's all I ask. Other than that, if you respect me, I respect you. You cool with me, I'm cool with you, whatever. You know? But, man, shit be real out here. That's all I'm saying. I got so many different videos that I can make. See, this video is even longer than what the hell I was even trying to talk. 43 minutes. Oh, shit, I should have been gone, y'all. See, I'm up there trying to teach y'all and talk to y'all and stuff. And I say teach. I'm a student just like I am a teacher. And I feel, and I'm not gonna lie, I get tired of motherfucking teaching people. People always want to tell me, you've inspired me to do this and you've inspired me to do that. I want somebody to inspire me. I gotta inspire my damn self. I motivate my damn self. You know, you motivated me to do this. Well, great. I want somebody to motivate me, inspire me, teach me something that I haven't sought the knowledge out for. You know what I'm saying? Like, the teacher can always learn, But I look at it this way. I can learn from my students. I'm a student of life, but I'm also a teacher. It's balance, you know what I'm saying? But anyways, I gotta get up off here. I gotta get my hair redone and shit, and I'm hella late. So I'll peace y'all later. Like, share, subscribe, and all that good stuff. Bye.